Hey everyone, how are you going? So today, I'm going to chase a waterfall. We're in tropical rainforest in northern Queensland, Australia, and I am, gonna hunt down a waterfall and shoot some footage. I've got a sweet, sweet surprise for you coming up, so check out the vlog, follow along, and I'll chat to you in a bit. So it's a 2.2 kilometer round trip, in and out. Actually, I don't even know if it's 2.2 in or round, I really don't know. The highway is just over there and you can kind of hear the cars, but they'll soon die off. Nandroya Falls is beautiful. I've been here once before and it's just a stunning little waterfall. I live pretty close by, like it took me, I don't know, maybe like 15, 20 minutes to drive up here, and then, probably like an hour to walk in. I've got a surprise. I told you at the start, I cannot wait to show you. You're gonna love this. So, sorry for that jump cut there. I've just about slipped what the surprise was, and then I thought, oh, I can't tell you yet. You've got to wait and see. So, without further ado, let's chat soon. Check out this little rock pool down here. So I've just crossed the walking path. Basically, I came from up over there and I crossed this stream down here. It goes across the path and then this little rock pool is just beautiful. Check it out. If it wasn't winter, and by winter in like tropical North Queensland, if it wasn't winter at 25 degrees Celsius, I'd probably go for a swim in there, but we've got to get there. I think I'm running out of daylight. See, that's part of the adventure today, in that I left it really late in the afternoon, so I'm hustling. I'm going as fast as I possibly can, because I do not want to get stuck out in the middle of the rainforest when the sun goes down. Really looking forward to getting in and out of here. Mum, if you're watching this and I didn't come home, then call the helicopter, help me. Okay, this is promising. So as I said, I've come pretty late in the afternoon and there's two choices. I either get the 3.5K going that way or the 1.7K going this way. Which one do you reckon I'm going? Yeah, you guessed it, that way. So we see a ton of these roots up in the rainforest here. They're called buttress roots, and basically they just stick out of the ground. They look majestic. These big trees are just enormous, and they've survived cyclones, they've survived years, maybe even hundreds of years. Like, they are ancient. Just to be here and to see them up close, like, you probably can't get the same perspective in the camera, but they're just stunning. Have a closer look at this. And well, this is not it. Don't be fooled. This is just a tiny waterfall on the way. It's called Silver Falls. The other Nandroya Falls are massive. You wait till you see it. But I thought you'd like this little one anyway. Still a nice little drop halfway along the walk right now. Actually, don't know how far we've gone in so far. So we'll just keep on trucking. Do you like these? I like them. Just through here is Nandroya Falls. I don't know if you can hear it through the camera, but it sounds awesome. Come on, have a look. Watch this. So here it is, this is Nandroya Falls. I probably should have researched just how high this waterfall is. I literally have no idea, and I'm really sorry for that. So we're in a bit of a rock basin at the moment. It's like a cliff face all around, like a bowl kind of shape, and the water's just coming through. I'm gonna unpack and set up this drone and we're just gonna jack it up and see if we can catch some awesome footage. It's a beautiful day today, nice and cool, great light. Hopeful that the wind coming from this waterfall isn't gonna blow my brand new drone into the water. So yeah, we'll see how it goes. Let's have a quick little chat about your drone right now. So this was my first kind of stress test, right? I've had this drone for a couple of days now, and I've been flying around in the backyard, and it's been pretty good over some cane fields and stuff. Check out this footage. Pretty safe bet, right? Like, other than a few like planes and power lines, not really planes, don't listen to that. Other than a few power lines, there's nothing really in the road. Then I came to the rainforest with a giant waterfall. Now, I thought I was gonna be okay, and the drone survived. However, if you look closely, you'll see there's some leafy residue. I almost lost the drone. I'm like twice. I almost lost the drone. See, all was going really well. I just I flew it straight out and just sat it into the middle there, and then I started to ascend and it just hit a limit because there's no GPS, right? And it was like, hey, we can't go any higher. You're now flying by vision only. And I thought, yeah, that's cool, no worries. So I was looking down at the controller and on my phone, and I was thinking like, how do I turn off this? Like, how do I override it so I can go higher? Because I wanted to get up the top of that waterfall. Anyway, then I look up, my drone has traveled right near the waterfall, and I've like gone, this is way too close, ripped it right back. It's come scooting across the water and has jammed straight into the trees above the water. I squealed like a little girl. I thought, there goes $2,200 worth of drone in the water on day two. I heard the trees like go, it sounded like it was just getting slashed, right? It was just like cut, cut, cut. And the blades, you can see there, like, I don't know if you can see. No, it's not gonna show it. Anyway, the blades there have like this tree residue on them after just chopping off the branches. I reeked it back out of the trees and it's just like hovered there on top of the water, and I've gone, this is just too much. Anyway, so I've sat for a while and I've tried to work out, like, you know, how can you override it? I couldn't. I came, I landed the drone. I played around with a few of the settings and things like that. Still couldn't work it out. So basically I just sent it back up and could only, this is so pathetic and I'm really sorry, vlog. But I set it up and I just sent it out and it just couldn't go any higher. So all you have is the pretty footage that you saw or that you're about to see. I'm not really sure in what order I'm gonna put it in the vlog. But like, that's all you see, right? It's just that part of the waterfall. It can't go up any higher. So what I'm gonna do, I'm gonna head back down this way a little bit, and there's like some kind of like smaller waterfall rapid kind of things. I might just give it another go and see if I can get like above and do some flyovers or something. I'm really not a drone flying expert, as you can see, because I've just punched it straight into some trees over water. Wish me luck. And I'll try and catch some more footage. And then, as you can see, it's getting a little bit dark now. So I'm gonna quickly try and run out and yeah, catch this footage and then get out of here before it turns dark. Thank goodness that I still have my drone. I appreciate life. I'm gonna be looking out of the Holy moly, did I just get some crazy shots. So over there in the brick basin that we were in there before, we must have been able to get GPS signal. Came down a little bit further, got GPS signal, far out. Like, those pictures are crazy good. There are, I can't even tell you how awesome it felt, like flying and having that perspective. Like, it was just awesome. I cannot wait to get back and see this computer and just see what it turned out like. Super exciting. Very nerve-wracking, putting up almost $2,500 worth of equipment, not being able to see it. It's coming down, the light's interfering with it, saying obstacle avoidance and won't let me move. It was just the sun, I thought it was a tree, I was like 150 meters up in the air. I don't know, my heart is racing right now. Best purchase ever. I hope that it turns out awesome. Okay, I am still buzzing. I'm just about at the end of the trail. I'm ready to get back in the car. The daylight is fading really quick. The sun's shining through the trees and it looks absolutely stunning. I just cannot get over how cool those shots were and how awesome it looked in the drone. I mean, that was just 150 meters up, right? Like, this drone can go a couple of kilometers. It's just that I have like a little safety switch in there to keep that switched on. I kind of want to get a lot more comfortable with it before I start actually shooting it like hundreds of meters high. If you like these kind of aerial footage shots and drone footage and stuff like that, go and follow me on Insta, because I'm about to drop a ton of this over the next few weeks and months, as well as all my other usual stuff as well. But I'd really love you to go there and check it out, because I am in love with that kind of content. And if you really like that kind of stuff too, please head over. If you don't and you don't really enjoy it, let me know, and I'll see if I can improve, or if you've got any tips on how I can make better drone footage or like better photos, send them along, man, because I really want to learn and I really want to know how to do better. So yeah, thanks so much for watching. I am pumped with this episode. I am pumped with the footage. If you liked it as well, hit a like. And if you haven't already, I think most of you have, but subscribe. That'd be awesome. There's going to be a ton of new vlogs coming out as I'm about to travel the world. What? You're traveling the world? Yeah, I am. I'll tell you more about that in the next vlog. Until next time, I'll see you all soon. Bye.